Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for July the 3rd of 2020, well, it is titled Lyn's Dark Nebula 1251. So what do we see here? Well, this is an example of a dark nebula in the plane of our Milky Way galaxy. And these dark clouds are the sites of star formation. So this is the region where stars are currently forming. Now, the dark areas are not an absence of material, but are actually the presence of excess dust, and in fact regions where dust is dense enough that it blocks out the light from behind. So if we could look behind that, we would be able to see additional stars. Just as there are stars elsewhere in the image, there would be stars behind that, but we can't see them because of the dust in the way. So dust will make everything seem dimmer by blocking out some of the light. So stars in the dusty areas will look fainter than they otherwise would. However, that is not the only thing that dust does. It also makes them appear redder. So if you look at stars right at the edge of the dusty areas, they tend to look redder than other stars. And that is because the dust not only blocks out light, but it also preferentially blocks out the shorter wavelengths, the blues and the greens. So stars looking through dust are going to look very red. And in fact, could we look at this in the infrared, even longer wavelengths, then we'd actually be able to see through the dust and would be able to see stars that are in the process of forming there. So we would see what we call protostars, and you can even see there's some examples of what we call Herbig-Haro objects, which are also associated with star formation. They're not the stars themselves, but the young stars can spew out jets of material, and those jets of material will excite the gases in the interstellar medium and cause them to glow. So the objects, again, are associated with star formation, but are really just clouds of gas in the interstellar medium that are being excited by the jets from these young stars that are in the process of formation. Now you can also look around. You may also be able to find yourself some galaxies off in the distance. So galaxies that happen to be off here, you can actually pick out some things that do not look like stars as you look around the image. And those are galaxies that are many millions of light years off beyond the rest of the material that we see here. So the stars and dust are within our own galaxy. Distant galaxies are far beyond that. And each of those galaxies, in many cases, could have nebulae, much like this one where stars are currently forming. So that was our picture of the day for July the 3rd of 2020. It was titled Lyn's Dark Nebula 1251. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be transient luminous events. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.